Hi students, let us continue with the topic DMA controller 8257. So in the previous video I explained about the what is the operation that DMA controller will exactly do. Now let us see the features of 8257 DMA controller. This DMA controller is having four channels. It has four channels which can be used over four input output devices. So totally it is having the four channels that are connected to this DMA controller. So those channels will be interacting with the peripheral devices. Each channel has a 16 bit address and 14 bit counter. So this you have to be noted. Each channel is consisting of 16 bit address as well as 14 bit counters. Here each channel can transfer data up to 64 kilobytes. So each channel 4 channels totally 64 into 4. Each channel can be programmed independently. So one channel is independent to the other. So can be programmed independently. Each channel can perform read transfer, write transfer and verify transfer operations. So actually the DMA direct memory access is only for transferring the data. It doesn't do any modifications. Okay. So it just read the transfer data and write the transfer and verify the transfer operation. Those each channel can do. It generate a mark signal to the peripheral devices that 128 bytes have been transferred. Suppose 128 bytes has been transferred, then it sends a mark signals to the peripherals. So whenever 128 means in that RAM you can store only 128 bytes. So if 128 bytes are over, it sends a mark signals to the peripherals. It requires a single phase lock. Its frequency ranges from 250 Hz to 3 MHz. And it operates in two modes. This direct memory access DMA controller can operates in two modes. One is the master mode, one is the slave mode. So master mode means whenever the CPU hand over the system bus to DMA controller, then it becomes the master mode. Suppose the CPU didn't send the acknowledgement to the hold acknowledgement signal to the DMA, up to that it becomes the slave. Whenever it receives the hold acknowledgement signal, then the DMA controller becomes master. Until it receives the hold acknowledgement from CPU, it acts as a slave mode. So these are the features of 8257 DMA controller. Now let us see the architecture of 8257. So here this is an architecture. So I said this DMA controller is having four channels: channel 0, channel 1, channel 2, channel 3. Okay, so these channels are connected to the peripherals. These channels are connected to the peripherals here. Each channel is holding, as I said, 16 bit address and 14 bit counter. Each channel is having 16-bit address and 14-bit counter. 16-bit address, 14-bit counter. 16-bit address and counter. So everything. So the four channels. Here each channel is independent to each other. They are programmed independently. This channel is programmed independently and this channel like that. Here this D request, DRQ0, RQ1, RQ2 and RQ3. So these are the four individual channels. Of DMA, these are the request inputs which are coming from the peripherals. Request inputs to the DMA controller. So total four requests can be given at a time. So here which are used for the by the peripheral devices for using DMA services. This DRQ0 is having the highest priority request, and this is having the lowest priority. Okay, so here this is having the highest priority and this is having the lowest priority. So first the peripherals are sending the DMA request by activating the DMA controller. So when it sends acknowledgement, whenever the CPU is hand over the system bus to the DMA controller, whenever it becomes the master, DMA controller becomes the master, then it sends the DMA acknowledgement to the peripherals. Okay. So first peripherals initiate the DMA controller for transferring the data directly to the memory. So then the DMA controller asks the CPU to hand over the system bus and make me as a master. So whenever the CPU makes the DMA controller master, then it sends the acknowledgement signal to the peripherals. So that's about the four channels. And the priority resolver will decide which request is having the highest priority. Now coming to this side. So this everything will be connected to the CPU, central processing unit. So here the D0 to D7 is the bidirectional data bus will be connected, and IO read and IO write. So here you are having the three components: data bus buffer, read write logic, and control logic and mode set registers. So this is a bidirectional data bus. And coming to the read write logic, here you are having IO read and IO write. IO read, which is used by the CPU to read internal registers of 8257 in slave mode. So it reads internal registers in slave mode, which is in slave mode, 8257 in slave mode. In master mode, this IO read is used to read data from peripheral devices during memory write cycle. And coming to IO write, it is used to load the content of data bus to 8-bit registers, 8-bit mode registers. Okay, so in master mode, it is used to load the data to peripherals during DMA read cycle. So that is about the IO read and IO write. And the clock, we know that the clock is nothing but it is do the internal, it is a signal which required for internal operations of 8257. Reset, it resets all the DMA controller, means it disables all the channels. Whenever we have done the reset, it disables all the channels. And coming to A0 to A3, A0 to A3 is a four least significant address lines. A0 to A3 is a four least significant address lines. And chip selection. Suppose in master mode, it enables the read, it disables the read-write operations. And in slave mode, it enables the read-write operations. Okay. And coming to A7 to A4 to A7. These are the higher nibble of lower order byte address generated by the DMA in master mode. And this is the ready pin. And HRQ, hold request, which is used to receive the hold request signal from output devices, and hold acknowledgement is sent by the CPU to the DMA controller by handovering the system bus. Memory read the data from address memory location during DMA read cycle, and this is from DMA write operations. And coming to AEN is nothing but used to enable or it is used to disable the address bus or data bus. AEN is only to disable, okay, disable the address or data bus. And this is a strobe signal, convert memory address to latches. And TC is the terminal count, which indicates the present DMA cycle to present peripheral devices. And I already discussed, whenever the 128 bytes of memory is transferred, then it indicates a mark signal to the peripherals that the data is transferred. That is by the mark. So this is about the architecture of 8257 of DMA controller. Thank you.